Let's look at a very simple implementation of a mutual exclusion lock. In terms of the instructions that the processor will execute in order to get this lock would be to come in and check if the lock is currently available, and that is done by this check. And if it is available, then it is going to set it to 1 to indicate that I've got the lock, nobody can get it, right? That's the idea behind this check and then setting this to 1. On the other hand, if somebody already has the lock, L is going to be 1, and therefore I'm going to wait here until the lock is released. And once the lock is released, then I can go back and check again to make sure that the lock is available and set it to 1. So this is the basic idea, very simple implementation of this lock. And how will I know that the lock has been released? Unlocking this is a very simple operation again. All that you have to do is reset this L to 0, and that will indicate that the lock has been released. So if I'm waiting here and somebody else has got the lock, they're going to come and unlock it by setting it to 0, and that way I will know that it has been released. I can go back, double check to make sure it is still 0, because somebody else could have gotten in the middle. If nobody else has gotten it, then I can set it to 1. So this is the idea of a simple, very simple-minded implementation of a lock algorithm. Is it possible to implement the simple-minded implementation of the lock using atomic reads and writes alone? Let's talk through this implementation here. Now, if you look at this set of instructions that the processor has to execute in order to acquire the lock, it has to first read L from memory and then check if it is 0 and store that new value, which is 1, into this memory location. So it's a group of 3 instructions that the processor has to execute. And the key thing is these 3 instructions have to be executed atomically in order to make sure that I got the lock and nobody else is going to interfere with my getting the lock. And as we know, reads and writes instructions by themselves are atomic, but a group of reads and writes are not atomic. And therefore, what we have here is a group of 3 instructions, and we need them to be atomic. What that means is we cannot have just reads and writes as the only atomic operations if we want to implement this lock algorithm. And we need a new semantic for an atomic instruction. And this semantic is what I call the read, modify, write operation, meaning that I'm going to read from memory, modify that value, and write it back to memory. So that's the kind of instruction that is needed in order to ensure that we can implement a lock algorithm. Now, several flavors of read, modify, write instructions have been proposed and or have been implemented in processor architectures, and we will look at a couple of them. The first one is what is called a test and set instruction. The idea here is the test and set instruction takes on a memory location as an argument. And what it does is it returns the current value that is in this particular memory location and also sets the memory location to a 1. So these 2 things that are being done, that is getting the current value from memory and setting it to 1, is being done atomically. That's the key thing, that it is testing the old value and it is setting it to this new value atomically. Another atomic read, modify, write instruction that has been proposed and or implemented is what is called a fetch and increment instruction. And this takes on, again, a memory location as an argument. And what it is going to do is it is going to fetch the old value of what was in the memory and then increment the current value that is in the memory by 1 or whatever value. So it could be that this may take on an extra argument to indicate how much it is going to change it by. But in the simple version, it might simply increment. In the simple version, it may simply increment the current value that is in the memory location by 1. As I said before, there have been several flavors of read, modify, write instructions that have been proposed in the literature. And often, generically, these read, modify instructions are called fetch and fee instructions, meaning that it is going to fetch an old value from memory and do some operation on that fetched value and write it back to memory. So for instance, fetch and increment is one flavor of that. There are other flavors like fetch and store, fetch and decrement, compare and swap, and so on. And you can read about that in the papers that we've identified for you. Okay, now that we have an atomic read, modify, write instruction available from the architecture, we can start looking at how to implement the mutual exclusion lock algorithms. Now, I gave you, of course, a very simple version of it. We'll talk more about that in a minute. And I'm sure that in the first project, when you implemented the mutual exclusion lock, you did not care too much about the scalability of your lock implementation. Now, if you are implementing your mutual exclusion lock algorithm on a large-scale shared memory multiprocessor, let's say with thousands of processors, you would be very worried about making sure that your synchronization algorithms scale. And scalability issue is fundamental to the implementation of synchronization algorithms.